At first, I was just telling myself I wanted to do IT, right? So I thought I was done. I knew what I wanted to do. But then later on, I found out that, IT is such a broad field itself. Like you really have to dial in into like what in IT do you want to do? I mean, there's security, there's coding, there's vulnerability, web application teams and stuff like that. And I came across security. And I really fell in love with it. I started off as an intern here at CI Security for about 4 or 5 months, and then eventually we got invested in. And then all of a sudden, we were emerging massively, and I was like, oh, whoa. They were looking for security analysts, and at the time, I just graduated with my AAS degree. I thought it was a perfect opportunity for me to really build my experience and add something to my resume. So I was like, why not? I love Bremerton. I love the company, I love the people around it, the culture, and I thought it was an excellent opportunity. So I took it, and that's where I'm at now. But now that we're emerging so fast, we had to bring on a whole marketing team and then a sales team, and then we had to build an office in Seattle. And Seattle is a great place to be if you're heading towards the security field. But over the past few years, I mean, it's been rapidly expanding. The reasons for that is because we have Amazon and Microsoft and Boeing right in our backyard. So, I mean, they're always constantly looking for people that are, fresh out of school and they know their security stuff. And I truly think that this is going to be the next Silicon Valley. I know a lot of people say that education isn't really important for the field and stuff like that, but on the flip side of things, while it might not be too important for your technical skills, it still helps you build those soft skills. So things like communicating with other people, presenting, working in groups, communicating with a diversity of people, I think that's extremely important in being a security analyst or a forensics analyst because, I mean, you're constantly researching things, you're constantly projecting things to, either your coworkers or clients, you're doing presentations, reports, of course. So, building those soft skills are extremely important, and without education, that's extremely hard to build. In my program, the kinds of things that you study are penetration testing, so using tools to target other machines, Linux, which is another operating system that's not really known as Windows right now, but it's emerging in the field. It's not just education, you really need the hands-on experience. So things like building your home labs at home and just messing around, like building virtual machines and just, oh, I read this cool thing in an article and I'm going to go home and test to see what it does. And just things like that, just doing things in your own time, going into an interview or something, if you talk about like a home lab or things that you experiment on your off time, employers, I noticed they really value that because it shows that you're not too dependent on school, even though it is important, but it shows a passion that you have for the field. Employers really like that stuff. And if you can manifest it in a way where you create reports and you hand it to your employer and be like, hey, look, this is what I did. And I think employers really value that. I mean, in the cybersecurity field, things are rapidly changing so fast. I mean, you have to be updated every day. Just read the news in the morning while you're having a cup of coffee. I mean, I think that's really a good way to stay up to date, and it's a good way to have conversations with other security professionals in the area. Especially if you're new in the field, just ask other people, hey, what would you do about this if this came in your network or something like that, and just being passionate about it. I see myself in 10 years still with this company, I think. I really like where we're headed here at CI Security. Since we're gradually getting out of that startup phase, we can still work on projects that help establish our company. And I think that's the real value that we have here, and it's going to help me later on down my career path. On top of that, I'm probably going to be teaching forensics soon at Highland College. So nowadays it's extremely valuable to have professors that work in the field that also teach it. And so they've already reached out to me, and I think that may undergo next year sometime. So I'm extremely excited for that. So that's just the beginning. I would say in 10 years I would probably be teaching like bachelor classes or maybe even university.